Hello, this is V. Sushmita, Assistant Professor, Faculty of Agriculture Sciences, Bharat Institute of Higher Education and Research. So, I'm going to deliver a lecture on pest of field crops and stored produce and their management. So, topic, pest of maize crop and management. Maize, Zia maize, the scientific name, is one of the most versatile emerging crops showing a wider adaptability under the varied agroclimatic condition. So globally, maize is known as the queen of cereals. Why? Because it has a highest genetic yield potential among the cereals. It is cultivated on nearly 190 meter hectare in all about 165 countries. So it's having the wider diversity of a soil, climate, biodiversity and management practices. So the management practices here, it is a very important that contribute of 39% in global grain production. The United States of America is the largest producer of maize, which contributes nearly 36% of a total production in the world. In India, the maize is grown throughout the year, that too predominantly in kharif crops. In Kharif season, with 85% of area under cultivation in this season. So in India, maize is the third most important crop after rice and wheat. It is account of around 10% of total food grain production in country. So these are all the important thing that is saying about the production of maize is how important. These production of maize is very important. At the same time, these production of maize is declined or decreased by some damage causing agent which is present in the field. What are all that? What is the damage causing things? Either it may be a pest or a disease or any kind of a nutrition deficiency. In among these kind of a damages, the insect pest damage is one of the important damage that is causing a more yield reduction when compared to the disease and nutrient deficiency. So here, the insect pest of maize, what are all that? The first one is the major insect pest. What are all the major insect pests in India? The first foremost important pest is stem borer. Maize stem borer, Chylopatalus. It's a Lepidoptera order. Next one is white grub, Phyllopega rugosa. It is coming under Coleoptera. Next one is rice ear cutting caterpillar or armyworm, Methyma separata. It is also an Lepidoptera. And next one is flower beetle or pollen beetle, Chyloba acuta. It is Coleoptera. Next one is wireworm, Agriotus species. It is also an beetle, that is a Coleoptera order. These are all the major insect pests that is causing a damage or the yield reduction in maize. Next. So the images of a major pest. The first one is a maize stem borer, the moth. And the second and third image, it is white grub. The second image is adult white grub. And the third one is the immature, that is an larval or caterpillar stage. It is called as a grub in a Coleoptera family. So it is a immature stage of white grub. And the fourth and fifth one is armyworm, that is rice ear cutting caterpillar. So this is an adult and this is how the larva will be. And the last image, it is a flower beetle or a pollen beetle. So these are all the major insect pest of maize. Next one, some minor insect pest. So first one is rice grasshopper. So it is a common that the grasshopper will be present in all grassland area. So next one is gray weevil, maize cobworm, cutworm, leaf folders, flea beetle, maize shoot fly, banded blister beetle, pink borer, green horned caterpillar, maize aphid, seed better beetle. So this minor pest and major pest, these pests are also a pest for a sorghum too. So one by one, the pest are explained, their life cycle, the damage caused to the maize crop, and how this can be managed. First one, maize stem borer, Caelopatalus, coming under a Lepidoptera order. So maize stem borer, it is one of a most destructive pest of maize and sorghum. So as I told, the pest of maize, it's 90%, it is also a pest of sorghum too. So here the damage causing stage in stem borer is their larval stage. The caterpillar which cause a damage to the crop of maize and sorghum by making a bore hole in the stems of a crop or a cobs, that means the ears of a cobs, either in a maize and sorghum. So this is their first damage caused in the stems and cobs. And how this caterpillar will be? So the fully grown caterpillar will be about 20 to 25 mm long, and it will be dirty grayish white with a black head, and on the longitude they will having the four brownish longitudinal strips, that means a longitudinal line like thing will be present on the upper surface of their larval body. And how the adult will be? The adult are yellowish gray mark. It is about 25 mm when it expand their wing. It is about a 25 mm length will be the adult. So this is how the insect will be. And next thing is the life cycle. The important thing, the life cycle of a stem borer. The insect breed very actively in March, April up to October. The mainly in this season, their breeding activity will be very high. The rest of the year, these stem borer will be remain in hibernation. So hibernation, where it will hibernate? It will hibernate in either in a maize stubbles, or after harvest of stubbles will be there. It will be hibernate in that maize stubbles or stalks or on the unshelled cobs. The larvae which pupate sometime in the March itself, and it will be emerge as a moth at end of the month or either in a early April. So this is also a kind of a hibernation, but it is slowly developing their stages. They are these stem borer are very active in night time. When they mate and lay eggs on the underside of the leaves, it is varies from one host plant to another host plant. Particularly in maize, it will lay their eggs in underside of the leaf only. It will mostly prefer the early crops. So the maize, when they are in an early stage, it will lay their eggs on the underside of the leaf. So how the egg will be? The egg will be a flat, oval, yellowish in color. It is laid in cluster form. It is not laid their egg in singly. It will lay their egg in a cluster form. In each cluster, it contains up to 20 eggs. So the stem borer female can lay an over of 300 eggs during their lifespan of 2 to 12 days. The moth lifespan is 2 to 12 days. In that lifespan, they can lay 300 eggs, and the eggs hatches in 4 to 5 days in summer. So within 4 to 5 days, these eggs are hatched in summer. So here this is a picture of life cycle of a stem borer, Caelopatalus. So first you can see the clusters of egg. It is laid as a batch. And from that the larvae is emerged. So larvae, you can see the dirty whitish, grayish whitish in color with the longitudinal line. And then it become as a pupae. The pupae, the next stage is a adult moth. So this is a life cycle of stem borer, Caelopatalus. So the continuation of a life cycle. So once the larvae, it emerged or came out from the egg, it will first feed on the leaf. So because of their feeding, you can see the shoot holes on the leaf. So it is actually it is feeding on the early or unopened leaf. Because of that, you can see the series of shoot hole symptoms. And then later on, they develop and bore into the downwards, that is through the central hole in the plant as it opens. So once it make a shoot holes, it is very visible and it is an indicating stage 2 where we have to take a immediate measure to manage the maize crop. Otherwise, the later on the plant will be lead to the complete death, and you can see the dead heart symptom. The central whorl of the plant will be completely become raw black, and then it will be dries. So this is a series of symptoms. So here the larvae will fully feed on 14 to 28 days, and it passing through the 6 stages. That means they will molt 6 times, and after making a hole in the stem, it will pupate inside the stem itself. So it will keep on feeding, and in that feeding time, once it complete the stage, all 6 stages in as a larvae, it will go deep into the stem and pupate inside the stem itself. So the life cycle of a stem borer, it's completed in about 4 to 7 weeks, and they are probably these stem borer can they will give a 5 generation in a year. So then the fully grown caterpillar of the last generation will hibernate in the stubbles, stalks, etc., and it will remain till the next spring. So the longest hibernation they can be. What is the damage? So as I told, the shoot hole is the early symptom. So here this damage is done by the caterpillar by eating inside the stem. So one of the important thing, it is eating inside the stem. So it is identifying this is quite not normal. The production of a dead heart, weakening of plant of a symptoms of attack of any stem borer. So this is a damage. So next, the important thing is management. How to control the stem borer in maize? So destroying the stubbles. So why we need to destroy the stubble? Because they hibernate in the stubbles only. We have to destroy the stubbles in each and every harvest. After harvest, we have to destroy the stubbles in the field. At the same time, we have to remove the wheat plants and also the alternate host, maybe a sorghum crop, any other crop which may be act as an alternate host for the stem borer. Because it will be become a cycle, it will be present in alternate host, again it will enter in enter as a main pest to the maize. So like for breaking that cycle, we need to destroy the alternate host. So here these should be destroyed by plowing the field in after harvest. So this is a first management practice. Next one is removal and destruction of a dead heart and destruction of infested plant. It is showing the early shoot holes or pinhole damage. So it is an important. So once you see the shoot holes, means immediately you remove that plant from the field. And destruction of crop residues, chopping and stem harboring diapause larvae could be very effective. Sometimes the diapause stage of larvae will be present in the crop residues. So we have to remove the crop residues also. And before planting, we have to go with the clipping of a lower leaf of a maize up to 4th stage. So these are all some mechanical and manual practice. In biological way, we can release a Trichogramma chylogenensis. So it is one of an important parasite that actually helpful to kill the stem borer. So what is the recommendation? 1 lakh per hectare on 10 to 15 days old field crops. So we can also spray 2 to 3 weeks after sowing, as soon as a bore injury in the leaf is noticed. So what we can spray, we can go with the fenbendazole 100 ml per hectare, cypermethrin 10 EC, that is 100 ml per hectare, or deltamethrin 2.8 EC at 200 ml. It should be mixed with the 150 liters of water in a recommendation for a hectare. Also, you can use a granular pesticide, fluorodone, 3% as a 12 to 15 kgs per hectare. So these are all the management practice for controlling the maize stem borer. The next important pest is white grub, Phyllopega rugosa, Coleoptera. So it is a beetle. So the white grub or the larvae of scrub, it is called as a chaffer beetle. So these beetle, that is a white grub, the beetle is also called as a chaffer beetle. So coming to the immature stage, that is a larval stage, it is creamy white in color. And here the important thing is, it will be C-shaped, it will be C-shaped with a brown head, and they are having a 3 pair of thoracic legs. So it is a well-defined thoracic legs. And some species of white grub, like a Phyllopega species, it will feed on the root of maize plant. So these Phyllopega rugosa, it is mainly causing a damage in a root. So the root is an important part of the plant. If it feed that area, means the production will be heavily damaged. So here the root damage is manifested by wilting seedling, poor plant stance, patches of tilted or lodged plant, which is showing the uneven growth. So these are all the damage caused or the symptom caused by this white grub. So we, in the early stage, you can see the wilting seedling. The small seedlings of maize will be wilted or dried. And you can see the poor plant stance. So if you normally irrigate, means the plant will be, the plant can't able to stand. So this is a kind of a symptom. And you can also see the patch of tilted or lodged plant showing the uneven growth. And the injured plant can easily pull out from the ground. So the next symptom, the plant can be easily pulled out from the ground. So when it comes to the third instar of a pest, that means the third stage of a white grub, it is often the most damaging one, which may be present in the soil for longest time. So their period present in the field is very, very long, that extend the damage, and the species composition varies from place to place. So in some area, the species may be vary when compared to other place. The larva is the major damaging stage. But also these adult, during the night time, it is causing a damage to the leaves. Life cycle. So what is the life cycle of these beetle? It takes a maximum of 3 years to complete their life cycle. Sometime if it is having optimum soil temperature, they may complete their life cycle in 2 years itself. So 3 years or maybe sometime 2 years. The female white grub can lay the eggs in soil in pasture land or in the fresh dung. So white grubs, mainly they are developing their breed in soil or in the fresh dungs or in the farmyard, many that we are collected and stored. And hatching of egg takes place after 2 to 3 weeks from that grubs, that is a immature stage or came out. The first instar larvae, it's begin to feed on the organic matter. So immediately it will not directly feed on the plant, it will feed on the organic matter that is present in the root area or in a rhizosome area. Later it start to feed on the plant root. With the cooling temperature, the larvae will descend into the soil profile, where they spend their good temperature, that is in a winter, inside the soil itself. When it is a spring, the larvae being the upward migration as the soil temperature increase. Depend upon the soil temperature, it will move inside and come outside. So the what is the larval period of this pest? The larval period of a white grub is 9 to 12 months. That's why it is a very, very important pest when it is more in number or when it is causing more damage, because their period of living in the soil is very, very high. It is 9 to 12 months as a larval period. The pupal period is 6 to 3 months. How to manage this white grub? So there are different management techniques as a IPM It is integrated pest management. So the different cultural practice such as plowing, so it is a normal thing, harrowing, hoeing, flooding and fallowing of field. All this plowing, harrowing, hoeing and all, it will exfoliate the larvae which is present inside the soil. So once it come out means it can be easily hand picked or it can be killed by using some other chemicals or some other form. So here the use of well-developed farmyard manure. So as I told before, these farmyard manure, the cow dung is one of a important place where it breed actively. So if we used the well-decomposed farmyard manure means it is very suited for their development in the field. And also the light trap can be used for collecting the adult beetle during the night time. And we can use a Metarhizium and Bivaria as a biopesticide. That how much we can use 1 kg of Metarhizium and 1 kg of Bivaria. It's mixed in a 25 kg of FOM and it is kept in a shade for 8 days. After it is very well mixed and it is placed in a shade, we can use these biopesticide along with the land preparation. So it is very helpful for controlling this white grub in present in the soil. And if it is a highly affected area, means we can go with the chloropyrifos. Chloropyrifos, it is 1 kg per hectare before sowing. So and also we can go with the seed treatment. Treat the seed before sowing with the 12.5 ml chloropyrifos, 20 EC per kg of maize seed. And we can kill the beetle by spraying 500 grams of carbaryl in a mixed with the 250 liters of water per hectare on the preferred host like Zephyrus, Guava and Grapevine, etc. And also we can go with the carbofluron 30 kg. It's recommended per hectare. It is randomly spread throughout the hectare of a land in a soil at or before sowing. So either you can at the time of sowing or before the time of sowing, you can use this carbofluron. So this is a management practice of white grub. Next one is armyworm, Methyma separata. So it is also an lepidopteran pest. So here this armyworm, Methyma separata, it is a pest of gramineous species. That means it is present widely in a maize, in wheat, in sugarcane, in jowar, in bajra. So it is having a different kind of host. So here this larvae feed voraciously. That is a main important thing that is causing a damage. It will feed voraciously and also it migrate from one field to another field. So like March, it once it feed in an area means then it move to the next area. So this is a two important problem. It feed voraciously and it migrate from one field to another field. So what, how the life cycle will be? So here the adult moth of armyworm are pale brown. So here you can see it is a pale brown in color. They live for 1 to 9 days and lay eggs singly in row or in clusters on dry or fresh plants or on the leaves. So this is how they will lay their eggs. And eggs are round, light green. The eggs will be round, the light green. When freshly laid means it will be light green in color. Later it turn into pale yellow and finally during the hatching time the egg will be turns into black color. So the egg hatches in 4 to 11 days from March to May, in 19 days in December to January. So this is a time where the egg hatches. So if it is a March to May, 4 to 11 days, the time the egg will be hatched. So the larva will be hatched from the egg. And if it is a December or January, the larva will be hatched in 19 days from the egg. So after it emerges from the egg, the freshly emerged larvae are very, very active. How it will be? It will be very dull white or dull white in color. and once it keep on developing, that is a molting, it turn into a green in color. So but it is a very active, immediately after it emerge from the egg, it will start their feeding activity. In spring season, the larval stage is complete in 13 to 14 days, but in winter it is prolonged to 88 to 100 days. So this is a huge difference. It is a 13 to 14 is 88 to 100, is a very very vast, very very unequal difference, but it is based upon the season. It is extend their life stages. That too, in pre-pupal stage, insect spin as a cocoon. So from larval to pupal stage, in pre-pupal stage, the larvae will be turned as a cocoon. In pre-pupal stage, last of 1 to 11 days during January to May, pupate usually takes place in soil at the depth of 0.5 to 5 centimeter inside the soil, but it may also occur under the dry leaves, among the stubbles or fresh tillers. Generally, these armyworm larvae, before they attain the pupation, it seems to slightly near the water channel. So it is a preferred to become a pupate in a cocoon form in near the water channel. The pupal stage will be completed in 9 to 13 days in May, and it will be varied in a winter month, 36 to 48 days. The survival of pupa will be depend on the moisture percentage in the soil. So the moisture percentage is an important thing for their survival. And the population buildup starts, particularly for armyworm, in the beginning of March, and it will be increased with the rise of temperature in spring season. So this is a complete life cycle about the armyworm. So how this damage caused? Before itself, I told it is a very voracious feeder. It will keep on eating the leaves, cobs, stems, or whatever may be. In early stage, they feed on the tender leaf in the central whorl of the plant. As they grow, they are able to feed even older leaf. So because of this eating on older leaf, the symptoms will be seen like a skeletonized, the leaf will be shown like a skeletonized, then totally they will eat. The grown-up caterpillar throw out the fecal pellets, so which are quite prominent in case of these caterpillar. So in case of a severe attack by the armyworm, the whole leaves, including the midrib, including the midrib, are consumed, and the field is completely look like a cat grazed by the cattle. So the larva of all instar will completely feed on the leaves, and particularly the fourth and the older instar of a larvae, it causing the main harm to the leaves, central hole of a plant, and also an cob of a maize. How to damage this? It is very simple. We can go with any kind of management, but the monitoring is one of important thing. Monitoring the field is very very important. If we monitor the field periodically, means we can identify the larvae emerge from the egg. So once you see the group of larvae in the crop, means immediately destroy that, immediately collect that plant and throw out or destroy it with the caterpillar. Collecting and destroying the caterpillar in early stage. So these management practice can be done by continuous monitoring of field. And if it is having a more number of caterpillar or armyworm in a field, means you can go with the 500 ml of dichlorovos, that is 85 SL, or 3 kg of carbaryl, 50 WP, or 1 liter of quinolpos, 25 EC in 250 liters of water per hectare. So these are all the recommendation for 1 hectare. Next one is flower beetle, Kyloba acuta. This is a coleoptera. Yes. there are pollen feeders are commonly on flowers, and it may be occur under the loose bark in debris. It will not completely present in the crop. It may also present in nearby barks or rotten trees or undeveloped twigs like that. So here basically it is a flower beetle. It causes damage to rice, maize, sorghum, millets, etc. They feed on the leaf, buds and flowers. Mainly it causes injuries to the by feeding and causing a destroying to the blossom petals of maize. So because of this, it can we can identify the discolors of blossom. So discolors of blossom is one of a important damage caused by the flower beetle or pollen beetle. So this is how this beetle will be. The adult beetle are shiny metallic green in color, which appears sometime in a red or deep blue in color. So we have a different kind of flower beetle, and they are irregularly covered with the hair, that too mainly on the underside. That means the that too mainly on the side and underside. Also in upper side also hair will be there. Mainly in the underside and the side, the density is more when compared to upper side. So life cycle, the female lays 100 of a tiny oval eggs. It's usually laid on a leaf or in a rotten wood. So it takes 4 to 10 days to hatch. The larvae passes through 3 to 5 inches. They vary in shape and size, depend upon where they live and what they feed. It's a very important for their growth. They generally appear grub-like outgrowth, so which is well defined. They are having head capsule, like a well-defined head capsule, which may be highly sclerotized. Now, normally the Coleoptera, the head will be sclerotized, that we know. The larva of a Kyloba species, it feed on trunk. That during their larval stage, they feed on trunk, branches, or a twigs of a drying plant. So the adult only feeding on the flower or the blossoms of maize crop. So the pupal stage is very usually found on the winter period, and the adult emergence is occurring spring season. Management, the same management, hand collection of adult beetle by using the sweep net. So we can collect the insect by sweeping the net in our field, and we can go with the 500 ml of dichlorovos, 85 SL in 1 liter of water, and quinol pass 25 EC into 50 liters of water per hectare. Next one is wireworm, Agriotis species. So the wireworm, it's a common, the name of wireworm is click beetle. So click beetle, which is originated from the habit of clicking its body into the air. So because of this habit only, it is called as a click beetle, clicking its body in the air. So here the adult beetle is very harmless. It only feed on the pollens. It is not causing any damage to the maize. But the larvae of a click beetle or larvae of a wireworm, it belong to most destructive soil insect pest, particularly for maize. So they are most important pest of a potato too, and other important crops like cereals and some germinating seeds. Depend upon the place, it may be present in different kinds of crops. So here the adult are light to dark brown or a dull in color, between 6 to 10 mm long and about 2 mm wide. So this is how the adult will be. So this is a click beetle adult. Next, the body of beetle is convex. So here in this image we can see it is a convex. The body of adult beetle is convex, and eggs are white, white in color, nearly a globe shaped, about 0.5 mm in diameter. So the larvae are a dark yellow, up to 25 mm long and 2 mm wide. The apex of last segment of a larval body is sharp pointed. Okay, so look at here. So this is a wireworm larvae, which is present in soil. And in larvae are hard, and they are having some cylindrical and shining of all those species. So here, coming to the pupa are white, 9 to 12 mm long. So you can see the pupa also in the first image. So this is a whitish 9 to 12 mm pupa. Coming to the life cycle of wireworm. So here the female lay eggs in clusters, or it may also lay their eggs in single on the root or into the soil at the depth of 3 to 15 centimeters. So the pupa, or sorry, the larva which is present in soil is very, very destructive thing for the crop, particularly for the seedlings. The total female fecundity is in their life cycle is about 50 to 350 eggs. They can lay up to 50 to 350 eggs. 350 eggs. The larvae develop during 3 to 5 years, and it will take up to 8 to 11 times of molting. So here the overwintering takes place at a depth of soil in 20 to 50 centimeters. It's like a hibernation. And the larvae prefers a moist soil. If the soil they present it's become dry out, means they will immediately migrate into the deeper soil layer. So the large larvae are able to strive to the several months. So without the food also they can be present in the depth of the soil. And a generation last, a single click beetle generation can last up to a maximum of 3 to 6 years. So depending upon their availability of food and their environmental condition, this 3 to 6 will be varied. So this is a life cycle. And in plant, it is present in the unplowed soil in a grassland, which represent their primary food source for wireworm. So normally the grassland area, it is a good source, the food will be available for this wireworm. And that is why the problem arises. So when we remove this kind of patches and we use that land for planting the maize crop, means these wireworm problem will be continued in maize crops also. So the because of this extent of life cycle, the wireworm damage may be persist to 2 to 3 years after also. So the most significant damage caused by this wireworm is to the germinating seedling and the seedling during the cold or wet spring. So this is an important thing. It is causing a damage to seedling which is started to germinate. So it is highly not preferable for the production. So the wireworm injurious is often associated with the small feeding holes on the base of the plant, which may kill the growing plant and the stunt growth. So it is quite normal. If the seedling is damaged, means the whole plant will be built, or the kill their plant growth will be stunted. So here you can see the damage, the wireworm which is present on the seedling, which become filtered and dead. So the wireworm feed on seed, seedling and underground part of the crop and bee. So the wireworm are more harmful for the grains, cereals, especially for maize, sunflower, potato, solanaceous crops and cruciferous crop, carrot, beetroot and turnip, etc. So these wireworm causes shoot thinning, first symptom, shoot thinning, stunting of a damaged plant, and the quality loss of tuber crops like potato. So this is a damage. So you can see the wireworm which is present in the seedlings too, in the image. So how to control this? So the crop rotation, which is you can go with the crop rotation of alfalfa and high glucosinated Braxia species may helps to manage this wireworm. And we can go with the field drying and summer plowing. So it is need more moisture soil. So if it is a summer plowing and field drying is kill, or these pests will be migrate from one field to another field. And flooding field with the water for at least 2 weeks is also a not preferred condition for wireworm. So use of wheat as a trap crop while growing maize and other cash crop is one of a management for controlling the wireworms. And as a biopesticide, we can use a Metarhizium bevoria. So as we used it in white grub. We can also use it in the wireworms too. So it is applied in soil. The metarhizium and bivaria is mixed along with the FOM in a 25 kg of FOM, and it is kept in 8 days in a shade region. After this, it is it can be used in the land preparation. So this is a management for wireworms, and wireworms are click beetle. So up to this, these are all the important pests of maize and their management. So the minor pest also an a pest, but when compared to this major pest, that is not causing more damage. So we have to give timely management for control the each and every pest that is causing damage to our field. So timely action is very, very needed. Thank you.